What's up, guys? Nepenthes here, and welcome back to another episode of The Road to Glory. We are approaching 200 episodes on The Road to Glory. I did not expect it to be this successful. I want to thank you guys massively for the support you've shown on the videos, for showing up in your droves every episode. Usually around 100,000 people per episode. That's genuinely unreal for me, personally. When I started this channel, it was for other games and apps, and I was going to kind of use it as a also The Road to Glory, and it quickly developed into The Road to Glory channel, just a second channel where I upload strictly Road to Glory. We have done a few other things here or there on it, but in general, not too much. It's just been Road to Glory. And I was thinking today, I was reading through the comments, and there's a lot of the same comments that I've answered before, and a lot of the same stuff that I've spoken about before. And I understand that the 100,000 people that might watch the video today, 50,000 of them might watch it tomorrow, and 50,000 different people might watch it. And then the next day, 50,000 of the previous set of 100,000 might watch it. And it's a bit of a mix. I'd say there's probably like a core group of about 160,000 people that watch the videos. And a lot of people can't watch them all the time every day. And I understand that, you know, they're super long. Like this one's going to be about 34 minutes long. They're quite very long videos, and they're out every day, and people's time is limited. And again, that makes it extra special just how many people of you show up. Like I'm genuinely amazed. So I know a lot of people miss a lot of stuff, and there are so many new viewers to the stream, so many new people to the stream, to the YouTube channel, to the channel, that, you know, this might be the first episode they've ever watched, and they might even see it and be like, oh my god, like, how's he got that team? Why has he got attribute cards on them? How did he win those players, or earn those players, or buy those players? This says it's a Road to Glory, but has he bought coins, or has he bought FIFA coins? Because it looks like he has. Like, there's always questions, because new people, new questions, new conversation. But when I was reading through some of the comments today, I had like an overwhelming feeling that, oh god, I'm just going to talk about the same crap again today. Like, and that's my fault for playing for champs. All I want to talk about is how unjust my losses are, and how I'm not good enough at this game, and how I need to get better. And I feel like a broken record with it. I feel like I've been saying the same thing week on week on week. And it's so crazy, and I tweeted about it today. Like, I feel like through this week specifically, I improved as a player no end, right? Because when I'm playing a game at a time, and there's no pressure, and I can actually take it one game at a time, I'm very happy. You know, we played, and I'm not trying to like go on or rub it in, but we beat six top 100 players during the week. We beat Bateson, Marshall. We lost overall to Marshall, but we beat him. We beat DJ Mario. We beat Phil SKS. We beat Medibob, who's actually going to FIWC. And we beat Stop Hitmarker, who's constantly in the top 100. So six top 100 players, and I beat them. And I played really good FIFA, and I was like, damn, man, like, this is awesome. Like, let me take this kind of, like, this mental fortitude and this gameplay. Let me take this into the weekend league, because, yes, I'm playing good. And then the weekend league comes about, and I win my first two, and I lose my first one. And I was all right. I was like, no, that loss was a fair loss. That guy was a solid opponent. He took his chances. I didn't take my chances. That's a fair loss, you know, that's okay. I then went on a hell of a win streak. We got to 8-1, and I'm feeling on top of the world. I played my 10th game, and that's where it fell apart, boys. That is where it fell apart. We lost to a guy who I feel like I should have beaten. I don't know why I didn't beat him. I haven't gone back to review the footage yet. I usually do that on Monday evenings. I'll go back and watch my losses and be like, look, what have I done here? Where can I improve? How can I get better? And it was a bit of a shock, because instead of being 9-1, which would have been a very reasonable start, I was 8-2, which is still, don't get me wrong, a very reasonable start. My expectations are probably to finish in a league right now, you know what I mean? Like, especially when I'm still not settled on a team, I'm struggling to let go of players, and we'll talk about that a bit in the video today. You know, I'm struggling to just decide exactly what I want for my account and for my team. And it is causing me some issues, but based on the fact that I'm still growing as a player, 8-2 is fine. Go into the next 10, you'll be fine. Well, in this 10, we got 7 wins and 3 losses. And one of those losses, again, was just a thoroughly deserved loss. You know, I don't mind if in games where I'm like as good as the opponent, or it's just a close game and we're both creating opportunities and I just miss mine and he takes his, I can take those losses on the chin and be like, fair play to you, man. You did a great job. You played well. There are those games against people who they just don't, like, they, I don't know, it's hard to explain, and it sounds like, you know, I'm making excuses, I need to get better, I need to learn how to do it, and you are so right. If you're sitting there thinking like, oh my god, here we go again, complaining about the losses that could have been wins, like, I get it, like, I genuinely get it, and you're so right, because when people say to me, in fact, somebody tweeted me today, he said, like, he doesn't lose in Division 1 often, and yet he can barely get 18 to 20 wins in weekend league, and he loses to people where he dominates the game and stuff, and I'm, oh, like, my first thought is, dude, you just got to learn to what shots to take. You got to learn to play a bit better. You got to learn the passing mechanics a bit better. You got to learn, you know, how to hang on to a lead and stuff. Because actually, of the three losses that I took here today, I was in the lead in two of the games. So, you know, when people say to me, "You got problems," they got problems. How do I fix it? I'm just like, dude, you just got to get better. You just got to get a bit better. Just get good. Just get good. And that, like, that's the answer. But ultimately, when you're in the heat of the moment, when you're in that game, when the pressure's on, it's so hard to just get good. And it's so frustrating for me that I know when there's no pressure on and when I don't have to play 40 and then, because of the other account, potentially another 25 to 40 games on a weekend, you know, I'm playing anywhere from 60 to 80 games on a weekend. When I don't have to play 60 to 80 games in 3 days, when I consider and think, look, if this is the last game of the day, that's absolutely fine. There's so much less pressure on me, and I don't know how to change that into Foot Champs. I don't know how to take that mentality and be like, look, let's just play this one game and see how it goes. And I don't know how to let go of the losses. I always go into future games hanging on to the loss of the prior game. And I did that again here. I won three in a row. I went to 11-2. And then the next thing I know, I'm 12-4. 12-5. I went from 11-2 to 12-5. And what happened was, is when I lost that, the third one of those games, when it became 12-5 instead of 13-4, you know, I sat there and I just walked out of my office and I was like, this is just, I can't do this. I can't keep being this broken man during Foot Champs. I can't keep letting this game get the better of me. I've got to figure out a way to do something better. So I sat down and I thought about the conversation I had with AAJTunes and hashtag Harry yesterday. And, you know, that we had a podcast. If you missed it, just check out A9Skills channel. It's on there. We did a podcast and, you know, just was taking on board all the things that I was saying in there about how people can progress and what Harry was saying and Jay and A. And trying to think, like, what's the best thing for me to do here? And the best thing for me to do was to go into the next game as if it were my first game. You know, Harry said something quite incredible during the podcast. He said it, like, he expects to win every game. Because unless you come up against somebody else who can also win every game, you're coming up against someone who is probably going to be worse than you. Now, I don't expect to win every game because I don't think I'm that good. But there is a wide pool of players in Foot Champs. There are, look at that foot. Oh, how you can see that goal, man. There's a wide pool of players in Foot Champs, you know. There's probably, at any given time, let's say we've got a basket of players, and I'm in the basket, and because of this basket is connected to several other, you know, this whatever EA server, let's say there's 1,500 people in this basket, and I'm one of these people. Let's say there's 30 people in this basket that are just head and shoulders above me. Let's say there's 100 people in this basket that are better than me. 200 people in this basket that are as good as me, and then something like 1,200 people in this basket who are not as good as me. The likelihood of me matching up against randomly the people who aren't as good as me is far better than the likelihood of me matching up against someone who is better than me. Which is probably why I always stay around the same win ratio of about 30 wins a week. For me to push on, two things have to happen. Number one, I either have to get super lucky and come up against no one who's as good or better than me. Or number two, I have to actually get better at this game. But I felt like I'd hit a ceiling a few weeks back. I felt like I didn't know what to do to get better. And then I analysed my gameplay, I analysed some pros gameplay, and I looked at some stuff and I thought, no, there's a few things here and there that if I just adapt this, change this, be, you know, change here and work on this, I'll get better. And I felt like I got better. But my lack of composure is still something that just breaks me. You know, I'll concede one goal and just everything goes. It's so disappointing. It's so, so disappointing that all it takes is one person, no matter how good or bad they are, to score one goal. And they get in my head and you know, it just it causes me to lose games that I should win. And I don't know how to improve the mental aspect of FIFA. I think in terms of ability, I'm quite high up there. You know, I know all the game mechanics. I know the tricks, the skills, the gimmicks. I know the corner techniques and the free kick techniques. I know that kickoff is a boost. I know how to defend it. I know how to attack it. Generally speaking, I know this game pretty inside out. I don't know how to stay sane up here whilst playing this game. So if anyone's got any advice or any tips, I would welcome it. And on that note, let's get to some comments from you dudes. Hafida Productions says, "Hey Nep, what controller do you use? I have a normal Xbox One controller, but I've just ordered the Elite controller because people say it's much better. What controller do you have and what customizations do you have? Do you like it? And if you do like, do you have like a scuff or something? Is it much better than a normal one? I saw in your Insta a long time ago that you have some different type of controller, but I couldn't tell what it is exactly." So I have a lot of controllers in general, yeah. I have loads of custom controllers and just controllers I've used through the years that I don't use anymore. But right now, I am using this, the Elite controller. I do have it wired to make sure I always have it wired. I don't have batteries in the battery pack because I personally believe the controller has a very, very slight amount of delay when it's wireless compared to wired. It's just the Elite controller. I do have some thumb grips on it because they just help. For me, that I find them to be a little bit useful. But other than that, I just used the generic controller. I took all the crap off the back because I don't like the paddles and stuff. That's the controller that I use. I don't think controller's necessarily that important to the game. Carl MCG says, "Nep, should I do SBC Suarez? Is he worth it? How much do you think it will cost and how much do I get back from packs on average?" I mean, on average, I couldn't tell you, dude. Like, it's a pack, isn't it? Like my average would be different to, like, if I gave you what I got on average and said this is what I got, so this might be what you get, it could be way off the mark just because of how the packs are. Is it worth it? Yes, it's absolutely worth it. This Suarez card is fantastic. You know, I've got a problem this year in FIFA that I've done so many SBCs that it forces my hand to what players I want to use. And I'm playing through this week, these 20 games that I've played, I've found a couple of things. There's a few players in this game that I absolutely love that I don't use enough. The Firmino that I have and the Nainggolan that I have. I find them to both be absolutely brilliant. So I'm sitting here now thinking to myself, maybe a team changes in order, and instead of using two teams where I'm sacrificing chemistry on both teams, maybe I switch back to one team. Maybe I sacrifice some chemistry on that team, but maybe I just switch to one team with the players that I really, really have good fortune with. And those players would be Ronaldo and Suarez up front again. Suarez at striker, the SBC Suarez, because he is just brilliant, right? Ronaldo at left forward. Eden Hazard still coming in at right forward. Obviously, I'd need two strong links to Eden Hazard, but I'd also need something to Nainggolan. So my idea would be to play Nainggolan at right centre mid, Chadli at centre mid, because that Nasser Chadli card is really good, and Firmino at left centre mid. Chadli would get perfect chem, Hazard would get perfect chem, Nainggolan would get 8 chemistry at that point, and Firmino currently would be on 8 chem. The defence would then be Azpilicueta, Reeds, De Gea, Coleman, but then Coleman would be off chem. I don't know. I'd have to have a look at it because, like, I wanna fit in the, like, there's a lot of players where I'm like, oh damn, that player was really, really good for me. And then I'm like, a lot of players, like, I used Ibrahimovic in the midfield again and I didn't like him again, so I took him out. And although I love Costa in the midfield, for me to get Nainggolan in, I'm either going to have to sacrifice Ronaldo and Suarez or some of my defence, and I think this defence is just too good to sacrifice. Or I'm going to have to sacrifice Eden Hazard. I just don't want to do that. I love the dude too much. He's one of the best players in the game, hands down. I don't want to sacrifice him. So to go back to the question, is SBC Suarez worth it? Absolutely, he's worth it. I think he's a fantastic player, and I think if you've got the coins, you should absolutely go on and go and get him. James Dennison says, "Hey Ned, would you ever consider building a Serie A team? I find lots of people use them, and it might suit your playstyle better." Yeah, I've considered it lots, dude. You know, like we've bought into Serie A teams a couple of times. You know, as I say, we've had Nainggolan, Florenzi, Manolas, Barzagli, Movember card. We use the SBC Buffon card. Like, I've got a lot of good players in the Calcio 8. Look at this goal. This is the game where the dude beat me, right? And it looks like he has a lot of shots against me, right? Because right there, for example, right in that instance right there, there was 3 shots on target there. One was a free, well, three shots anyway. One was a free kick that was going out, and the keeper broke physics, defied physics to keep in. Then the rebound was saved, and then the rebound of the rebound went in. And this is one of the games where literally I'm like, I don't know how I lost this game. Like, I just couldn't keep my composure. I scored, I equalised. He just ran into me down the other end. Nothing I could do. And he just runs into the player and gets a free kick. I've got the wall in the right area. The goalkeeper's in the right spot. He doesn't even try and save it. And then I'm all out of attack. You can see I've only got three defenders back instead of four because my centre-back's up the field. So I'm all out of attack trying to get back in the game. And he ends up scoring. But look at this, guys. Look, like, I know the final whistle was 5-3. And I know this is only one instance in a 90-minute game that wasn't overly important. And I know it looks like he dominated the game. Well, he had a lot of chances. Not necessarily more possession. But look at this. His hand goes through the bar to keep in play a ball that was going out of play at 2-2. And that made it 3-2 to him. And then I came back to 3-3. But should that, like, that should have just been out for a goal kick. And then who knows what would have happened in the rest of the game. I might have gone and taken the lead and won. I might still have gone on and lost. But those things trigger me so much that it causes me to lose more games. It's so stupid. I want to have a real good look at my team after this weekend league. I really do just want to sit down and think, okay, what players are an absolute must-have in the team? And what players am I just using because I've got them as an SBC and I've got lots of games on them already? Because I would rather have the must-haves and then build a brand new team around them than have players like... Who would I say I'm using just because I've got like Chadli. I find the Chadli card to be really decent, by the way. And again, what a crappy goal to concede. I tackled him like three times on the way in there. I'm watching this back getting more triggered. I would say that Nasser Chadli card is very good. Medium work rate, 6'2", quite well rounded, lacking on defending a little bit, but in general, not too bad. However, I'm sure I would prefer somebody else. I'm sure there's somebody else that would be in there that would also be very good. You know what I mean? I want to take a long, hard look at my team at the end of this Foot Champs run. Go take something new into Division 1. Take players that I know are overpowered and that just make this game work. Maybe look at getting, Pogba or Infong Kante. Maybe look at bringing back KDB. Maybe look at bringing Anthony Martial into the team and putting Ronaldo at right forward. Maybe look at going for Suarez, Ronaldo, Modric, Marcelo, and Sergio Ramos. You know what I mean? Like, really just look at what I can do to improve my game and make sure that when I'm in these sort of games again, like this game here, look at this, one tackle there, gets the ball back, pops off him there, gets the ball back. Like, I was dominating this dude, man. He just didn't deserve his opportunities. He didn't earn them. The game gifted them to him. And that's my fault largely for poor defending. But again, look at this. Watch this. Look, who's he trying to shield off? What's the defender trying to shield off? I was controlling the defender there. I was just pressing sprint. I was trying to run to the ball. And the defender, I'm conceding that goal to make it 4-3. And I can't believe it, man. I can't believe I'm losing these games, right? So I need to find something that works for me, man. I need to just go and get something. Stop caring about the SBCs. Go back to some items, some cards that work for me. Very tempted to go back to Lacazette card. You know, go Lacazette, go Ousmane Dembele, and go with Depay at left forward. And then just sub Ronaldo on. You know, like something like that. Do you know what I mean? I am sacrificing a lot for Ronaldo. I do think he is the difference. He scores just so many goals. He creates so many chances. And like in general, he mentally beats people straight away. When my team shows up, they see that Ronaldo, instantly they're like, oh my God, he's got Ronaldo. Like it straight away, it beats people like instantly. But if I've got a different attack that I could use that would get me more wins, I would probably prefer that attack. But Ronaldo, Suarez, like I'm so tempted to maybe just go get Messi, get rid of Hazard. You know what I mean? Go throw Messi down there, get rid of Hazard, maybe put a legend centre mid, a Portuguese legend centre mid in at the central centre mid spot, and then I could do anything with the left side and the right side. But again, now I'm sacrificing players and teams and stuff to fit one more player in. You know, it's crazy. I don't know what to do. Like, the Suarez and the Ronaldo are just so brilliant. It's hard to not have them in the game. And this Suarez is brilliant on 8-chem. 10-chem, he doesn't really get that many more stats. But, I assume it would make a little bit of a difference. But anyway, moving on to the next comment. Buck Lau says, hey Nat, do you think chemistry and chem styles actually exist? I've used slow players like SBC Jonas with a Hunter card, which increases his pace to 85 apparently, but it still feels as if he's 76 pace striker. Keep up the good work, bro. Yes, I do. I believe chemistry and I believe chem styles exist. I just believe people overestimate what 10 extra pace actually is. You've got SBC Jonas, you say. One of the things to notice when you put a Hunter card on him is he goes to 88 pace, right, which is high, but he only has 84 sprint speed, which isn't that high. You know, that's not actually that fast. And on top of that, his balance is only 70. And as you may or may not know, agility, balance, and reactions are all important to pace and how fast the player actually feels. So I believe they were. I like, for me, I don't know what you think the difference between 76 and 88 pace is, but it's not worlds apart. You know what I mean? Like, that, in the grand scheme of things, that's close in numbers anyway. But if you took a guy with 76 pace and started him on the halfway line, and a guy and Jonas with 88 pace, or if you took the two Jonases, one with 76 and one with 88, and ran them from the halfway line to the goal line, you would notice that the 88 one would finish marginally faster. Because the difference, we're talking margins, you know? They cover the course of the field so quickly because it's a video game and the way time works in the game and stuff, that the difference between even 75 and 90 pace isn't genuinely that much. Especially considering then balance, reactions and agility to be important to the player's pace, and the fact that sprint speed and acceleration are important to the pace, you know, and to do with the fact that a player on the ball is always going to be slower than their pace suggests than the player off the ball. And then when you consider stamina and how that affects someone's pace, there are multiple reasons why he doesn't feel like he should be better. What you've got to remember is Jonas has 2,138 in-game stats, right? That's a lot of stats. When you apply chemistry style, it only adds 90 extra in-game stats. It doesn't even add 90 extra in-game stats. It redistributes 90 in-game stats, because when you have basic chem style, you still get that 90 boost. It just goes all over the card. But when you apply a specific chem style, it just redistributes and refines where those 90 extra stats go. When you're talking about a player with 2,138 in-game stats and you're adding 90 to him, he's just going to 2,228. You're not giving him that much of a boost. I personally believe that chem styles are far more apparent and far more noticeable on players that are low end, because the stat boost is huge for them. But chem styles on players like Ronaldo, like Suarez, like this Hazard, like Messi's, they're so far less important because the stats of these players are so high as it is, that in fact, in some cases, for example, Cristiano Ronaldo, let's take Ronaldo as the example, even the 94 Ronaldo, when you apply a Hunter card to him, which I have, he only gets 8 acceleration and 7 sprint speed, so he only gets 15 points there, whereas usually 30 points go into the pace, because you're capping him. So in some instances, in the high-end players, you're actually hurting them by, or like, they don't get as big a boost from a chem style as someone who's low-end because of the fact that they already have so many high stats. So, yeah, I absolutely do believe chem styles work, and I believe chemistry works, but the reason why I'm happy to not play players on 10 chem all the time is because Suarez is still so good on 8 chemistry that I would rather Suarez on 8 chemistry than Benzema on 10, or, you know, somebody else on 10 that you might put there. But anyway, guys, this is going to be the end of the gameplay real quick. We end up 15-5, not too bad, but I'd expect a little bit better from myself from the first 20 games. Could have been worse, could have been a little bit better. Maybe 16-17 would have been better, but this is the end of the gameplay, guys. Let's get into the live section. So, guys, 20 games deep. Saturdays, man. This weekend I had to play on Saturday because I was at I'm not actually red. It's just the lighting in the room. I want to start playing 20 games Friday and 20 games Sunday. I didn't have time this Friday because my daughter was ill, so I was caring for her. Like, I was up real late. Excuses. Regardless, but bottom line is I didn't have time to play 20 games on Friday. So I had to start playing the games today, and I didn't do as bad this Saturday as I did last Saturday. But I did do quite bad. I got 7 wins and 3 losses in our current 10-game stint. Two of those losses were most definitely avoidable. One game I just lost fair and square. You know, and two of them, like, I added the dudes. Let me show you, actually. Not that it makes any difference what their record is, because, you know, you could have started off as a horrendous player and worked your way up. You could relegate yourself through divisions and put yourself back up again. But we lost to this dude. Now, this guy, he's played a lot of FIFA, right? 1,337 wins, 1,046 losses. That is a lot of games. And his match earnings are nowhere near as high as mine, which means he probably rage quits a lot. You know, if he goes 1-0 down, he probably just bang, quits. Because when you rage quit, you just get like 100 coins instead of like 600 coins or whatever, right? So we lost to this guy, XL Jumbo there, and I checked his Foot Champs history and stuff. Like, last weekend he finished on 18 wins, last month he didn't even get into gold. Like, I guess he doesn't play all his games, maybe he doesn't qualify every week because he wasn't very good. And I don't know, man, I managed to lose to him. And the other dude I lost to, a bit of a better record actually, this guy here, barely positive, but yeah. You know, it's mad frustrating. I lost to this dude 734, 67 to 617, 14 trophies. He only got 16 wins last, or 18 wins. One of them got 16, one of them got 18. Just mad frustrating, man, mad frustrating. And I thought this week I'd been past that, you know. Last episode, 10 games in, I was 9-8-1, 10th game, and again, we lost a game that was winnable. And I thought, I genuinely, like, in my head, I came into this weekend with such a positive attitude. I came into this weekend thinking to myself, look, I have beaten some of the best players in the world this week outside of Foot Champs. I'm taking on, I won Division 1, 8 wins, no losses. I've gone back into Division 1, as you'll see, I think we're 2 wins, no losses, 3 wins, no losses in our next run into Division 1. We're stomping it. We're winning games that we should win. And then it comes to Foot Champs, and my mind just... And I know, like, I know it's excuses, but I will say, I will preface this by, it is my fault. There are a few things that happen that screw me up. For example, in one of the games that I lost, De Gea puts his hand through the bar to tap in a ball that was going out anyway, and then the guy was there and put the ball in the back of the net. Like, that changed the game for me in a stressful game. That was the difference there. That allowed that guy to win. You know, there was lots I could have done to change that, I get that, but in the pressure cooker that is Foot Champs, man, I can't deal with it. I just can't deal with it. I don't know why. I just can't. It's really frustrating. I thought I was better than that. I genuinely thought, every week, I work on my play, I work on my team, I work on a lot, and I'm never good enough. By the way, Guedes, we bought him for $16,250. I've listed him up for 29,000. I hope he sells for 29,000. He's currently playing for PSG. He started for them. So his price went up to, there is actually one with a bid of 30,000 on it. I'll show you. Our first ones to watch investment paying off, I guess. Guedes. No, always do it the wrong way around. Always, every single time. Guedes special. You'll see there's one here. Where is it? Oh, it must have expired already. But as you can see, like, oh no, there you go. 30,000 bid on it. It must be fresh, maybe. No, it's not even fresh. Maybe because it's a can. But in general, I've got mine listed up at 29,000. There's probably some at 27,000. What have we got? Oh, wow. There's loads listed up at 30,000. Holy crap. So my 29,000 is... How much is it beaten by? Oh, loads. Oh, I suppose... No, we're back down to 26,000 or so. Hopefully he does something in the game and his price goes, you know, skyrockets up, because I'll happily take 29,000. I bought him for 16k. I'd happily sell him for 25k, to be perfectly honest. If he doesn't sell here, but he's still going, I would quite easily sell him for 25k, make 10k, and then buy him when his price drops again. Looking at these teams, guys, looking at how we've performed, what we've done right, what we've done wrong, this team finally has the perfect chemistry now. We've got 10 games minimum on all of them. I think I prefer this team. I think this is my, I was going to say the other one was my first team, right? And you'll notice, actually, I took Ibrahimovic out of the team. He's just not good enough. Well, no, that's a lie. He is one of the best players I've ever used in this game. He is just not a good centre midfielder. His medium-low work rates... Like, he will genuinely just stand in the middle of the field because he has a low defensive work rate and watch players just burn past him. He won't even try and get it. Unless I'm controlling him, if the AI is controlling this Zlatan card, he will quite happily just watch someone. Like, and that's my fault. He has low attacking work rates. What was I thinking, playing him in midfield, right? So I put Dele Alli back into the team, and I quickly realised I don't like Dele Alli. I thought I enjoyed him, but for just Firmino is just so much better. So I'm very tempted now, for the last 20 games, to see how it works, to get rid of Manolas, basically just to play with the team that I want to play with on this account, and that would have Firmino there. This would be the midfield. As much as I don't enjoy Dele Alli, I don't have alternatives to put in to get links, right, for Alonso and for the midfielder. But I think I'm just going to play with this team now instead. And I actually love Azpilicueta. I find him to be phenomenal. He is very, very, very good. But I don't know which player I play him instead of. Reed, probably the logical choice because it's only physical. But actually, Smalling... What's Smalling compared to Reed? Reed's got less... Ooh. I might go Azpilicueta and Reed for a bit and see how that goes, right? And that opens up the opportunities here. Because I'm not enjoying Dele Alli. People said to me, get inform Isco. So I am very tempted to go ahead and sell on Manola, sell on Alexandro, sell on... place him on a transfer list, get rid of him. Place him on the transfer list and get rid of him. And then just use fitness cards for the last 20 games and see if it improves my performance at all, you know? Honestly, this Nainggolan card is so good. It's just a shame that I can't get him into the team without sacrificing massive chemistry, right? Because I would love to get him into the team. In actual fact, we probably could get him into the team if we put Manolas at centre-back, Florenzi at right-back, Nainggolan at right centre mid. Yeah, I think that would actually work. This video is going to be hugely long. But also, Dembele got a goal and an assist, has a potential upgrade. So his price has gone up a little bit. Not too much, as you can see. It's actually come back down to 220 or so. But yeah, I'm going to have a look at... Like, the reason why I like Firmino in this team is because he's big and he's got 4-star skill moves, 4-star weak foot. He does wonderful things for me. I find him to be really, really good. Nainggolan, however, is small. He's a dogged player, high work rate. He's got very similar stats actually. 144, 17 and 24 to 187, 30 and 27. And they both played a lot of games as subs. I don't know, man. I don't know. I would love that Roberto Firmino card in the midfield, but I'd also be happy to not use him and to put in Nainggolan instead. But then taking out Coleman. Coleman is just a beast. He's the best right back I've used. So yeah, I'm not doing that. I'm keeping Firmino. I'm going to go and buy Isco. I'm going to sell some players, buy Isco, see what we can do with that, and see where we go with that, essentially. See if that works out. If I do that, yeah, we all get 10 chem there. I might just play with that until I can get hold of Isco. But this team, guys, this attack is just brilliant. It is genuinely just brilliant. Ronaldo, again, his goals are lacking a little bit because he is coming off the left forward spot, not as a striker. So he scores a few less goals, but he gets a lot of assists. And at least 5 to 8 of those games are games that have either been disconnects or rage quits in the first 5 or 6 minutes where he hasn't got, you know, a goal. Luis Suarez is just amazing. 103 goals for your man. 166 goal contributions in 153 games. And Eden Hazard, he's slipped off quite a lot. 821 goal contributions in 827 games. Because his physical is so low, he gets subbed off first all the time. I used to never sub him off because I'd have Heung-Min Son and Theo Walcott that I'd be like, look, Hazard's so good that I'd prefer to have him on the field on low energy than have him off the field. But now because we've got Suarez, because we've got Ronaldo, because we're bringing on players like Lacazette, like Dembele, like Ibrahimovic, it's like, you know what, let's bring Hazard off. So that's what we've been doing. But anyway, guys, the team, I'm just disappointed in myself and the way I played, but this is the team. That was the end of the gameplay. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time. I'm out. Peace.